afternoon. I'll be presenting the topic Experiences of Healthcare Providers with Integrated Sexual Reproductive Health and HIV Services in Oyo State. I will start with the presentation of the abstract. There has been wide agreement in some countries where there is generalized HIV AIDS and high reproductive disease that integration of SRH and HIV services is highly important. Integration is thus assumed to increase accessibility to and uptake of health services. It also ensures better use of resources as it improves efficiency at cheaper costs. But there are, however, few studies on the significance of healthcare providers' experiences on integration of SRH and HIV services. So the method that will be used to carry out this research involves the use of administration of semi-structured questionnaire in-depth guide on 32 key frontline providers in the state. The roles of providers is very critical to integration, but they enjoy some benefits as well as face some challenges that needs to be addressed. On the introduction, integration of SRH and HIV services is very important in countries with generalized HIV/AIDS epidemics and high morbidity, such as my country, Nigeria. And we were told that the services is very poor in Nigeria. The success of integration is, however, dependent on the behavior of healthcare providers. The experiences of providers can either be personal or at operational levels. The findings from this study will be critical to the successful implementation of the integrated health system in the state, in the country, and its sustainability in the state. It involves the qualitative study, which is conducted among frontline providers in selected health facilities to investigate the significance of the experiences with service delivery in the state. The statement of the problem: the integration of SRH and HIV services is very beneficial to both the client and the personnel involved in service delivery. Therefore, the role of the healthcare professional is very crucial to resources. However, there are currently very limited studies on the experiences of the service providers, which can affect service delivery of integrated services. In addition, there seems to be some constraints that can affect performance of healthcare providers or integrated services delivery that needs to be identified. The benefits of integrated services in Nigeria cannot be ignored, despite the poor awareness of the system in the country. The success of the integration services, however, depends on the experiences of the health personnel. But because of the limited information available on experience of healthcare provider with integration, this study is just justified to be carried out. The objectives of this study involve the investigation of healthcare provider experiences with integration, to ascertain the significance of healthcare provider to the performance of integrated services, to explore the factors that can serve as a mitigating factor to successful delivery of the integration, and come out with useful recommendations to improve the service. The methodology involves the study was carried out in health facilities in 15 local government areas in Oyo State, Southwest Nigeria. And the study population involved 32 key workers working on SRH HIV integration services in selected facilities. The study design involved qualitative study using grounded theory. And this grounded theory approach involved inductive methodology which is the systematic generation of theory from systematic research, and the emerging concepts from such a study is used to develop the results of the research. The sampling method that was still used here was multi-stage sampling, and in multi-stage sampling, we first of all consider the three senatorial region in the area, then draw out a sampling frame that was generated and stratified into three levels of healthcare, that is the primary, secondary, and tertiary. From the simple random balloting that was used to select two tertiary healthcare facilities, two secondary healthcare facilities, and 28 PAC from where the respondents were selected for the administration of the idea. The respondents were selected by purposive sampling, taking into cognizance their years of experience and the number of years that they have worked on integrated services in the state and their facility. The data analysis after administration of the IDI, the interviews were translated and transcribed. Then data analysis was done manually together with my research assistants. And key things were the benefits and challenges encountered by the respondents. The ethical profile was sought from Oyo State Ministry of Health Research Ethical Committee, DOMISA at Ibadan. The result now, the socio-demographic profile of the respondent was as shown on the slide below. The professionals involved are medical doctors, registered nurses, CHO, CHOs, and their years of experiences ranges from 2 to 10 and greater than 10 years. The health facilities, one respondent from tertiary, two from secondary, and 29 from primary. Then, as part of the result, too, there were some positive impacts of integration according to the respondent. And part of these positive impacts are improved healthcare services. We can see what one of the respondents wrote here, what they stated there that was quoted verbatim. When we say something is integrated, it is under the same roof and people will not waste time. As you have counseled them on HIV, then you jump and counsel them on family planning too. It makes things work smoothly, no wasting of time. You can see the source, female nurse, the name was not stated to cover their, that is to prevent their names from being known by authority in case they say something that might be critical to the system. Another positive impact is because of the integration, there were increased uptake of and access to healthcare system. A pregnant woman that reported in ANC, for example, now they have opportunity of also accessing sexual reproductive health system. Another impact is reduction in comorbidity and mortality of patients. We are aware that a lot of people just give birth anyhow before without even undergoing family planning. Some of them now, once they go to hospital, they counsel them, giving them family planning methods. Most of these people too, they are also directed to HIV units so that they can be able to know their status, whether they are negative or positive. Those people that are positive, they now refer them for things like prevention of mother to child transmission. So we are saving the life of the patient as well as limiting the number of deaths from those people that are positive to HIV and also accessing sexual reproductive health. One of the critical things that the respondent, the healthcare provider, says is that the integration services expose them to a lot of capacity improvement processes. We can hear from what a female doctor says. She says, then to us, it has a lot of benefits because it helps in widening our capacity, at least patients present in diverse. Ways and it helps it challenges us mentally. That is part of capacity improvement. Then the constraints to implementation of integration. When the opinion were being sampled, the thing that recall the most common constraint that they were mentioning is shortage of manpower. Yes, there will be shortage of manpower because those people that were presently in service in the state, the government were able to pay them. So many of them leave the hospital. Some of those people that left the hospital and that were trained by implementing partners, they left with their knowledge, thereby rendering the hospital shortage of people with know-how on how to implement the integration services. They also mentioned some constraints like infrastructural upgrades. Most of the infrastructure are down and they need upgrading. Some of the rooms that they have is very small. They need improvement. They need the government to build additional rooms for them to be able to carry out the integrated services. They also talk of lack of essential commodities that they supposed to use for the integrated services. Another critical thing that was common from their constraint that they said is poor motivation. If you are very conversant with things in my country, Nigeria, especially those people that are from here, you know that some of our states were yet to be able to pay for the services rendered by their civil servants. That is also happening in the state where I carried out this research. There are another things, language barrier. Oyo State, where the research took place, is domiciled by Yoruba tribe. Some people like Hausas or Igbo that go to the facility to access the first services who doesn't know how to speak English or Yoruba might have problem of accessing care. We can hear what a female nurse has to say about this constraint. She said the silence is just the staff, shortage of staff. Manpower is one of the challenges, because this affects the workload, since one person will be the one doing four procedures at the same time. Then there is no enough space, the same room is used for everything. You can see the synopsis of the benefits and challenges of sexual reproductive health. Under the benefit, job satisfaction, improved staff attitude and build mutual relation. You can see increased knowledge and skills, experience gathering, convenience of service, increased service uptake as stated before, reduction in key experiences and clients. But the main challenges that give rise to all these ones is poor staff. When there is poor staff, there is increased workload. Then, poor and irregular salary, tough working environment affecting them physically and psychologically, and stress as a result of too much workload. Then more time spent on patients, increased waiting time. Then, how do we now improve the implementation of this integration service? We can see that the main thing they say. Hello? Okay. So how do we improve it? Employment of more staff, as we can see here. Then the discussion to investigate healthcare providers' experiences with integration. Most of the providers are highly experienced and skillful in rendering integrated services. This was also attested to by some existing literatures. To ascertain the significance of healthcare provider to the performance of the integrated health facilities, the success of integrated services depends on the performance of health workers, as corroborated by Dussault and Dubois, 2004. To explore factors that can affect healthcare providers. Respondents complained of increased workload because of poor number of healthcare providers available, poor salaries, poor incentives, poor infrastructure, and adequate staffing. Then to come up with recommendations, there should be good policy environment that will be provided by the state government.